Good afternoon, brothers. I'm recording this class on literature review. Make sure I will not be behind, and I apologize for any inconvenience. I was trying to record the class on Google Meet, but it seems like my account does not allow me to record such a meeting, so I then preferred to go back to my Zoom meeting, the one I'm used, and it has never disappointed me. All right, so we are to start today the class to pick up from what we have just done yesterday. Yesterday we are looking at the preliminary pages of the project. And then we also looked into chapter one, which is the background of the study. Today, I want to present to you the literature review. Literature review is chapter two. And then I want to emphasize as I begin this class into two major things. One is that we have the objectives, objectives or research objectives of your study, and two, we have the variables, dependent and independent variables. I want to make clear this point. If in my previous classes it was not so clear, today I want to make it clear. The objectives that you have here are the ones that are going to guide you in your questionnaires, which means for each objective is likely to be one section. Thus, first we will have section A, which is usually section A deals with demographic information. And then this objective number one that I have here, students, discipline or counseling influence students discipline, is likely to be my section B. And then here, attitude of students towards peer counseling, it's going to be my section C. And then adequacy of time allocated for peer counseling is going to be my object section number D. We have one, which is section A, which deals with demographic information. Then we have here two, section B, section C, section D, and section E, which deals with role of school administration. So I want to make it clear. That's why yesterday we are trying to look why not research questions. So the research questions would simply mean to translate these objectives into research questions, into questions, and then that would lead you into your questionnaires. But it's just the same, you know, just the same. So, and then when we come to the questionnaires, we are going to look into that. And then the other thing that I want you to look to pay attention is the conceptual framework where we find the independent and the dependent variables. Dependent and independent variables. So these variables, if you look at them, somehow are figured in our objectives. But these variables that we have them here, the way they are the same ones that will appear in our literature review, which is chapter two. Well, now we move on to chapter two. Let's start with Francis Abok. We have here chapter two. He first gave an introduction. You know, as you say, this chapter reviewed literature. This chapter revealed the literature that is related to the study, all those things, or the stories, and then the chapter is divided into the following areas. So he described here, which means we have here 2.0. And then we have here 2.1, which is this one, disaster preparedness and facilities equipment. And then 2.2 is going to be this one. So you actually present as a kind of introduction to how you have organized this chapter 2, which is literature review. Here we also have somehow they have further noted that literature review helps. The literature review in this study indicates perception, students' perception. We have them here, teaching methodology, and then we have effects of biological jargons on performance. So it's a kind of introducing your chapter 2, your literature review, to the reader. No, if you want, as you see, you can also quote, but if you don't want, you can just ignore that part. It's not a must you introduce, but if you do, no problem. If you quote, no problem. So I also have here, all right, but I have here my introduction. I wrote nothing, so I just went straight to the point, which is 2.2. And then my first variable was students' attitude. So I then started here, students' attitude. I mean, giving a summary, because in literature review, we review the studies that have been carried out by other researchers. That's the point. You just bring, all the things that they have concluded, the findings, you bring them into your study. For example, here, I have this guy in 2010 carried out a study on the attitude of secondary school students towards guidance and counseling service in across River State in Nigeria. Their study revealed that male and female students differ in their attitude towards guidance and the counseling services. Female students show a high positive attitude towards guidance and counseling services than their male counterparts. Besides, geographical location is a strong determinant of students' attitude towards guidance and counseling service in schools. Students in urban areas are predisposed to guidance and counseling services than those in rural areas, which means all these things that are just below here, that are below students' attitude, all these things that are here are just related to the students' attitude. I'm not sure whether you got the point when I was mentioning that, their study revealed that male and female students differ, which means the attitude of male students towards peer counsel is different with that of female students. You are getting? So everything that will be here should be related to that attitude, or students' attitude towards peer counseling. And I want to, let me go to this other before I emphasize something. And then here we also have students' perception towards biological jargons. Perception entails how something is regarded and understood. Hence, it is an act of being aware of one's environment by physical sensation, which symbolizes individual's ability to comprehend. All those stories, you just bring them out, but which is related to students' perception. That's what I wanted to emphasize, which is related to students' perception. And then you have a lot of stories here. It depends. Someone yesterday was asking how many pages should we write in the significance of your study. And then you might also ask, how many pages are you going to write for each variable in chapter 2? So it's up to you. As long as you find information that supports your study, your variable, you bring them out. But again, when you bring them out, don't just bring irrelevant information that dates back 20 years ago, yet you have a lot of available information that dates to just 5 years or 10 years ago. You need also to measure, to weigh, which kind of information do I bring to my project? Does it mean that whatever information you bring is going to add value to your project? If you feel like there is an information that does not add value to your to your project, just leave them out and get the relevant information, the current information, the information that you feel like if anyone comes in contact with my project, will actually find something significant. And then once that person finds something significant, that's when the person is going to use you, you know? I mean, quoting early 2021. Well, next year, no? Early 2021 or early 2022. You're getting the point. Mushima, but this name is a complicated. Don't even know which one is your last name. But anyway, let's go to Kondwerani. Kondwerani 2022. You know, this is the point that they are going to bring because they know that they have found the treasure in your project. If your project is full of jaga jaga, as people say is there, jaga jaga, you know, well, they might use you just because they want to escape from availability of, you know, literature review material. But otherwise, if someone reads and finds that there's no substantial information, they'll just leave it out. So I would advise you to take time to do well your project, even if you will not meet the standards, but at least you have made a lot of effort to make sure you give the best to yourself so that once it is completed, in the next 10 years, you look at it, you feel like I did my best. I gave the best of myself to this project of mine, and you'll be proud of it. For those who speak English speakers, you can even print a copy or two. Take it back. Go to a university that you have there. You can even give them. Even when you go to Malawi, print it. No, with permission of your supervisor, print it. Make sure there in Malawi they have a hard copy of your project, of your study. Let them use also, because you know that there are also people studying there. Right. We continue chapter 2. And then another question that you might ask that I want to emphasize is, how do I find information, for example, in disaster preparedness? How do I bring just the studies of people that just did it? You know, well, once you read, yesterday we spoke about the abstract, and then we saw the conclusion of the study and the recommendation, you know? If you go also to your questionnaire, to the questionnaire of that person who did the study, specifically, you can even access it in chapter 4, which is analysis of the project interpretation. You can actually see the part that he did, for example, this one, disaster preparedness and facilities and equipment. You can just go there and see how did he conclude, what was the finds. The find might be like 50% of males have agreed that the school has this, that does this. And then at the end, it comes up with like his conclusion, like it implies that, which you are going to see later. And then he also brings a stat that he brings to support that findings, which we are also going to see it later. I don't want to complicate too much, but I want you to really get what chapter 2 is all about. All right, and then we have here, we give the stories and whatsoever it comes. It comes, depends how many pages you're going to bring, but you know. For me, others you have seen 3-4 pages, but for me, I think on this one, students' attitude, I think was the very, very one variable that I found a lot of information about it. And I think I went down the line with 2 pages, and others went down the line with 4-5, doesn't matter. As long as you find relevant information that supports your study, even if it is 2, no problem. All right, even if it's 1.5, no problem. But if you find, make an effort. That's why when last week, if not last week but one, we were trying to see some of the issues that are related to project. We talked like your project must, you, when you find a topic, it must give you sufficient data, like for your literature review. If you are finding a topic that does not have literature review, how are you going to come up with your variables and then support your literature review? How are you going to review studies? No? You already know the inconvenience of that. So make sure you get a topic and try to get studies that are related to that, and then that will really support your literature review. And then here we have the second objective, no? I guess, or second objective, or you have the second variable. I hope you still remember this point, second variable. And then here we have the second variable. It goes all down. This one of Boston goes. He actually found sufficient literature review on his study. Yeah. He has a lot of all history, you know. For Moshimo is doing history, you actually be glad to read this part. Then you have a lot of issues here. Then we have another one here. These are the, just the objectives, the variables. I want you to get clear at this point. Your variables, you know, your variables. You have, if you have three variables, I remember my Mwalimu, Ms. Maina, telling us, if you have two variables, it's not enough for your project. But if you have three variables, it's sufficient for your project. But if you have four, it's also good. But the point is that it's going to be extensive, you know? It's going to be a lot of issues that they're going to look into, like four variables, no? Talk about this. If you have about three variables, it's sufficient. But if you feel like you have four, no problem. Take the challenge. We are the passengers. Take us to where you want us to go. Good. Then we have here. Have here the one, as you can see, this one of a Bokoso. For this variable, he found also sufficient information, you know, and then he has the fourth one, yeah, because it started with 2.0, so we had 2.1, we had 2.2, we had 2.3, and then we have now 2.4, which means it denotes, it gives me the idea that there's four. And then it gives the summary of literature review, and then it's just here. No, the summary, like each chapter attempted the survey of related literature review pertaining to the topic under study. The chapter focused on the highlighted research objectives or the variables. So they are just the same, you know, because what you include in your objective is what actually comes from your variables. So you first design your variables. It's going to be funny. You first design your variables, and then from variables you got your objectives, you know. It's like you are doing your chapter one, you can start with your background. But again, when it comes to objective, you need to design first your conceptual framework. So what are my variables, dependent variables? What are the independent variables based on my topic, you know? And then you draw it. Once you have it, you say, these are the variables that I want to work with, the independent variables. And then you bring those independent variables in form of objectives into your objectives, and then that's when you ask to find out whether, you know, that. And then if you want to turn it into research questions, you just say to what what is the perception of students, all those things, as João yesterday was explaining the questions, how to turn it into questions. So some researchers actually, like Mr. Warambu, he likes when you give the summaries of each chapter. Here we have the summary of literature review research chapter 2, and then you have a lot of these, you know, all the stories that are here. Amid these various studies, the literature review shows the gap still exists between the aforementioned studies and the current study. Therefore, there is a need to investigate disaster, you know, still what he brought back, what was already said in chapter 1. Then let's go to this project. I still remember that time, there was something, like, for example, let me try to read the time. The reasons given to support this claim, the study revealed that population respondents of 83% pointed out that the time allocated for guidance and counseling in their schools was not adequate for the proper implementation of the program. You know, remember that my topic was on peer counseling, but having peer counseling, I cannot talk about peer counseling if I don't find out whether there is guidance and counseling, because peer counseling is inside the package of guidance and counseling. So it's somehow related. When I talk peer counseling, I'm talking actually of guidance and counseling, but only that peer counseling is more specific, like one-on-one or group of students of the same age that share the same characteristics that come together to advise each other, to make sure that they support each other while at school. Yeah, so that's why guidance and counseling is featured here. And then you have here, these are the ones, a later study emphasizes was given by Tatata on the time allocation. She observed that the insufficient allocation of time for peer counseling per se lies on the fact that it is not mentioned in the school timetable. All these things, I'm just talking about the time allocated for peer counseling. And then I remember this was the short information that I gave on a school administration, which means the little that I found in the chapter 4 when I was doing of other projects, the little that I could find was just what I brought here, which means if before there was three people who did the research that talked about the school administration, with me who talked about also school administration makes four, which means if on the next year someone comes to do the same project and talks about school administration, which means he already has four projects that to talk about. I got three and I gave the contribution with mine, so makes four. You're getting the point. So that person, if he also talks about the school administration related to counseling, you become the fifth person, So that's how actually studies come, and then we add up when we saw the characteristic, if I'm not mistaken, characteristic of research project, we saw that the studies add up, as we do studies, that's how they come up, the knowledge comes adding to each other. And then we also have here, this according to Yamwaka, education system in Kenya, recommended peer counseling services should be established in educational and the training institution. Peer counselors must be trained on physical development. Peer should be offered by professionally trained and mature people, all those things. If you want to get more, you can go to my project and read across. So then we have here, actually, there is quite a lot of information here. Oh, never realized. So we have the school administration. Remember that under my variable school administration, I also talked about the environment. I guess this was the shortest. Environment, school environment, you know, whether they are quiet rooms and the noisy compound, you know. So I found something, you know, and I just brought it. The little that it was, I brought it, but it was sufficient. So that's how we finish this chapter 2 on literature review, which is very vital to your projects. And then, as you can see, neither Boston or I did the summary of literature review. Neither we also did on chapter 1, which is the background of the study, but Aboku, because of his supervisor, he had to do it, you know? So it depends the supervisor. If your supervisor accepts it, do it. If it does not accept, then well and good, move on. That's why the moment you hear that, you know, this person is going to be your supervisor, just get people, actually recent people, who have been supervised by that same supervisor, and then see how the project was done. So just follow the footsteps. Follow the footsteps, you know? Let the project be your mentor. That project be your mentor. Yeah. All right. So this was all about chapter 2, which is on literature review. I will still emphasize here in literature review, we review the studies that have already been done by other people, like their conclusions and whatsoever, and then you bring them here. Right. I was trying to forget something. Let me see whether we have it in this one. I will tell you just a moment. Something that is very important, very, very, very important. Here I can't find, but it will come. If I'm saying it is important, it's because it will come. Here, Mr. Warambo was not so much concentrated into it, right? Let's go to Boston to see whether I can find it. Boston also seems not to be having it. Yeah, seems not to be having it. It seems not to be having it. Yeah, but let's go to my project because I'm actually a scholar and I know that I have it. Right, this is the word here. Researcher 2020. Then we go ahead, we see Researcher 2020, another one there. We go ahead again, let me see if you find another researcher. No, researcher, that researcher is referring to me. I cannot say Manuel or Simon 2020, but you just say researcher because it's already known that I am the one who did the research. So Researcher 2020 found that the time for peer counseling is adequate, though the time is never enough for students to express fully or to fully express their issues. Now, why did I bring this Researcher 2020? That, as you have seen, it is in my project, but it's not in Boston's project. It's not in Francis Aboku's project. Why? When I was doing my project, my supervisor, even those who proofread my project, or the second readers, they one of the comments was this. There is no relationship like, you know, in chapter 2, literature review, you have reviewed the studies that have already been done by other people. Now, when you go to chapter 4, you did your own study, you're analyzing your data. But how do you harmonize the idea that you found, that you revealed in chapter 2, and then to harmonize with what you found? Do they relate? Do they come together? So how do they come together? They come together by this. When you do your chapter 2, and then you go to chapter 3, you go to the field. When you come back with data, you analyze that data, right? I guess you are getting my point. You analyze that data. Once you analyze that data, you come here to chapter 2 and take the study that supports that particular question that gave you results in chapter 4, and then you go and support there. You say this study is an agreement with Henry 1997, who found that this is that. The same way you do it then, chapter 4, you take Henry there. Let's say you took Henry there. Let me just be clear on this one. Let's say the study is being done by João, right? João in his study revealed Henry, that Henry found that this is that, right? This is in your chapter 2, João. This is in your chapter 2. When you go to chapter 4, after you have gotten the data you're analyzing, you found that the same question or related to that question that you asked in your chapter, in your questionnaires and you're analyzing, it relates to what you have revealed, you have done in chapter 4. And that, not chapter 4, sorry, in chapter 2. And that in chapter 2 relates exactly with what Henry found in his study. So you take Henry now from the literature review, Henry, that part there. You take to chapter 4 and say, this study agrees or disagrees with what Henry in 1997 found, that there is not enough time for peer counseling. Right? You got this point. This is the first part. Now, for you also to give credit to your study, you now get what you found there in chapter 4. You come back to chapter 2 also and then put there. Somehow this what is here. You put here. And then you say, dear researcher, don't say João, or Gabriel, but you just come here, maybe the paragraph that relates really to what you did. And then you say, yeah, you come here and say, the researcher 2020 found that time for peer counseling is adequate, you know? Means, João did your study, you did your study, and found that time for peer counseling is enough, although it's not mentioned in the program. Right? This is what exactly or somehow relates to the study that Henry did in 1997. Eh? And Henry found the same. Found that there is adequacy for peer counseling. The time is adequate, but it's not included. That's why people feel like there is not enough time for them to express their issues. Right? Yeah? In your chapter 4, you mention Henry, that Henry in 1997 found it. But when you come here to chapter 2, you also mention the researcher, that's how you actually make a bridge, you know, make a link between your chapter 2 and your chapter 4. But when we look into chapter 4, you are actually going to understand more. And then let me still go to these other variables. Another variable here. I actually just brought them at the end. Like for example, researcher stop. Like for example here, students who receive assistance from the life skills-based peer counseling, according to Fabrianti and Mula, okay, prove to be more effective than students who get help from conventional peer counseling. Now, here comes, this is the guy that found it, but I come here now. The researcher established that peer counseling exists in schools, as most of the students, this one and then this one, confirmed, yeah? Which means peer counseling exists. Here I was talking about what? Let me see. I was talking about, students' attitude, so, if peer counseling exists in students, it means there is a positive attitude, you know, towards peer counseling. So it's there. Then confirmed. However, something still needs to be done, as few students, these ones, have not benefited from peer counseling. So the very first question that after the demographic information asked the students, even teachers, is, do you have peer counseling in your schools? So out of 196 around there, told me out of that, 134 told me that, and these teachers, all of them told me that there is peer counseling. But these 55 students, which represents 29%, told me that there is no peer counseling, which means they have not benefited from that. That is the analysis that I made. No, that they don't benefit from that. So this was the very point that I wanted to emphasize. You know, how do you bridge, you know, how do you bridge your chapter 2 and your chapter 4? So this is how you do. For example, this same study that I found here, yeah, this same study that I found here, research, is because I did in chapter 4. But the same way that you see this one is coming here at the end, is the same way that in chapter 4, I would bring this guy here and say that this study that I told you, I found here, agrees with maybe this one who found that students or life skills based peer counseling are proved to be more effective than students who get help from conventional peer counseling, or something of that nature. But when we go to chapter 4, we are actually going to see more, and the heavy work is actually in that chapter. All right, so I guess I am going to stop here. I just advise you, just read it, try to understand what I tried to say. If you feel you did not understand, after you have carefully listened to what I have said, but if you still feel you have not understood, let me know, and then we are going to clarify the issues. And I'm going to clarify the issues when we are all together, so that your question might be someone's question, and my answer might be everybody's answer to their question. Yeah. So I wish you all the best, and we will meet in the next occasion. Thanks very much, and blessings from the Almighty God.